Welcome to this quick tutorial on how to create live streams by using Wirecast with our streaming video provider platform. To get you started, we're going to log into our panel. And from our panel, you have two choices. One is either you use a pre-existing broadcast by clicking on the Broadcast Now button, or you need to create a new live broadcast player. I'm going to show you quickly how to do that now. So we click on the New Live Broadcast button. And here we're going to give it a name, so my broadcast, for example. And here we can choose usually which type of delivery method we want to use, secure streaming or HLS, for example. So that's a choice that you would need to make. And you get tags, etc. So for the moment, we're just going to leave it as normal and save the changes. And to commence our broadcast, we're going to start the broadcast by clicking on the Broadcast Now button. This will open our broadcast panel, which can be seen here. In the broadcast panel, we need to select a source. So for Wirecast, we simply select a Wirecast as a source. And you will be given the RTMP details, which we're going to type into Wirecast in a minute. I usually suggest to click on Start Broadcast once you have set it up, because the live broadcast player will go into listening mode, meaning that it will start and stop the broadcast depending on when you click start and stop broadcasting within Wirecast. So I'm going to leave it personally in listening mode. If you don't leave it in the listening mode, please remember to click start and stop broadcasting from the broadcast panel. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to start Wirecast. And here's Wirecast. So what we're going to do now is do the Wirecast settings. So to do so, click on Output and select your Output Settings. Here we're going to choose RTMP Server to set up our RTMP details. And you can give the RTMP Server a name if you wish, like RTMP Server 1. And what we're going to do here is choose our encoding. So here you can choose your quality, 1080p and below. So I'm going to leave my main stream as 720p. And now it wants the RTMP address and the RTMP stream. And to do so, I'm going to go over here to our broadcast panel, and you can see the RTMP URL and the stream name. So we're going to click on copy, which will copy the RTMP URL. And we're going to paste it in here. And the same thing we're going to do now for the stream name. We're going to copy the stream name and paste it into the stream. So that's it. So now it's fully set up here. And this is for the main streaming server. So this is your main server that you can stream with. If you want to do single bit rate, you leave it as it is now. Or we click simply on the add button to add multiple ones. It automatically copies over the details we gave it beforehand. So we can call it RTMP server 2, for example. And we can choose a lower quality, such as 360p, for example, to send a second stream as a backup stream. The difference is you're going to leave the stream name the same, but at the end we're going to add a number 2. The number 2 stands for the secondary backup stream. And we're going to click on add one more because I want to have 3. You can send up to 3 separate streams at the same time for multi-bitrate streaming. And this time I'm going to choose something even lower, like 240p. And once again, we remove the number 2 and we change it to number 3. So if we go through all of the servers quickly, we're going to have the first server, just plain and simple, second server with a number 2, and third server with a number 3, and all of them have changing qualities as well. So we're happy with this. We're going to click OK. And we're now in the setup phase. We now need to add something to stream. So you could go here and add a camera or something. For my tutorial, I'm just going to add a MP4 video file, as I wish to stream an MP4 video file. So now you just simply select what you want to stream, and you will see it in the preview. And to start streaming, it's very simple. You click on this button here, which will put it over here, and then you click on the Start Streaming button here, the big stream. So this is now sending it to the player. So if you click on my broadcast and click on the preview button, you will see that the stream is coming through without any problems to the live stream player. So you can now stop the stream simply from Wirecast itself by clicking the stream button. And I'm going to close Wirecast as I don't want to save it. And that's it. It's as simple as that. Now that the broadcast is streaming and live, I've stopped it, but to do your publishing, you simply click on the publish button and choose your publishing methods and preview and generate the embed code for your website. It's as simple as that.